Tonight we're going to have back straps, and my wife Danielle is going to narrate on how we're going to cook these up.
So this is the way that we usually prepare the deer back straps. There's lots of different ways you can do it, but this is what we like the best. This back strap came from a really big doe, so this is actually cut in half. It was twice as long. But basically what we're going to do is we're going to sear it on all sides to get a good crust on it, and then finish it off in the oven just to cook it through. And then we're going to make a quick pan sauce for it. So over in my skillet on the stove, I have about 2 tablespoons of butter, and we're going to heat that up just over about medium-high heat. And what I've done to this already is I rubbed it with a mixture of 2 teaspoons of fresh minced thyme and about an eighth of a teaspoon or a pinch of black pepper, and about 1 teaspoon of kosher salt. I just mixed that together and I rubbed it over the back strap, and I just let this set here for an hour. What that's gonna do is it's gonna let those seasonings start to season the meat. Okay, we're just gonna add this to the skillet. You can see why you definitely wanna cut it in half. There's no way this whole thing would fit in here. But if you wanna cut it in half and do 2 of them, that's fine. You could just put one on each side of the skillet. And we're gonna just sear this on both sides until it gets nice and brown. Okay, so once you have a good crust on both sides, good browning, we're gonna go ahead and take this skillet and put it into a 350-degree oven. Make sure it's an oven-proof skillet. Make sure there's no rubber or anything on the handle that's gonna melt. And we're gonna bake this until whatever doneness you like. We like it medium, so we're gonna cook it till it's 140 degrees in the center. And that's gonna take anywhere from like 5 to 10 minutes. Okay, so we got this out of the oven. It was 140 degrees for medium, but if you like medium rare or whatever, go with that. I'm just gonna tent this with foil to keep it warm. And we're gonna work on our pan sauce then. We're just gonna add 2 teaspoons of vegetable oil, and we're gonna heat this up over medium high. Just keep in mind your handle is gonna be hot, so don't touch it because it just came out of the oven. And we're gonna add 1 shallot that's been minced, and we're gonna cook this just until it starts to get soft. It's gonna take about 2 minutes. Okay, so once this starts to soften, we're going to add, this is 1/2 cup of red wine and 3/4 cups of chicken broth. And we're going to let this cook until it reduces down to about 1/3 of a cup. It's going to take about 4 to 6 minutes. You're just going to let it simmer, and you can start to use your spoon to scrape up some of these brown bits on the bottom of the pan. And we're also going to add 2 teaspoons of brown sugar. Okay, so this has been simmering for about 6 minutes. It's reduced down. So the last step is we're going to add 3 tablespoons of butter. We're going to take this off the heat. I've turned the heat off. We're going to whisk the butter in. And this butter is cold. It's been in the refrigerator. The reason you want to do it like this and whisk in 1 piece at a time is if you would have this over the heat still and you'd whisk this in all at once, it would just kind of turn greasy as the butter melts. But if you do this slowly with cold butter, instead of turning greasy, it actually makes the sauce really smooth and silky. So you just whisk each piece in here until it melts, until you have all 3 tablespoons melted. So once the butter is all melted, I'm just going to stir in, this is 1 teaspoon of fresh minced thyme, just season it with some salt and pepper. like to cut it just into about half inch, 3/4 inch pieces.
Another very good recipe, quick, easy, very good. Best way to do backstraps.